that the opinions and the words that you hear expressed on this program do not necessarily or ever reflect those of WAIF, its staff, its board of trustees, its programmers, anyone associated with WAIF except for moi, or those of my co-host Taper Jesse, who'll be in here in just a bit, or those of my guests, which I don't have any tonight. We're going to crank on a lot of Grateful Dead. Going to do some rare things. I don't play a lot of albums. I play a lot of live Grateful Dead. So as a compromise to this, I'm going to play a live album. Ta-da! But first, wanted to let you guys know that we do have underwriting available. And you can go to WAIF's website, WAIF883.org, for more information on that. Also, that's where you can find out how you can become a member. We are member-supported radio, WAIF883.org. Just donate $25, and you can become a member. Support us. We have membership drives each fall and spring. If you have less than $25, any donation will help. We won't turn any dollar away. If you have more than $25, I know we have ran in the past the $150 brick in the plaza deal, where you get a commemorative engraved brick at the WAIF Media Plaza. At the $250 level, you get to be a DJ for a day. Come in with Jesse and myself. We'll sit you down and show you around the radio station and do a program with you. And you can even get to pick the music if we agree with it, of course. Disclaimer there. So, yeah, that's kind of cool, too. So we got all kinds of good things here at WAIF, and we depend on you guys, so help us out. And speaking of helping us out, our annual membership meeting once a year will be Sunday, September 17th at the New Thought Unity Church over at 1401 East McMillan in Cincinnati, Ohio. At 3 p.m., we will begin registering everyone who's a member, and we will meet from 4 to 7 p.m., Please bring a picture ID, your driver's license, of course, a membership card, an ink pen, a copy of the alert, some paper, whatever else you want. I mean, within reason. I mean, you can't bring a goat or anything like that. Anyway. And since we are member-supported, every once in a while, Ramblin' Rob, once a year, Ramblin' Rob, there is a soiree, and I want to invite each and every one of you guys down to it here on September 23rd at the Urban Artifact in Cincinnati, Ohio, north side at 1660 Blue Rock Street, Cincinnati, Ohio, 45223. The Urban Artifact, a great place to have fun, enjoy a beverage, and just kind of chill. And this is a great event because 100% of the proceeds benefit WAIF. We're going to have a great lineup for you, and also a silent auction with some incredible gifts. See Ramblin' Rob's Facebook page for more pictures and info on that. But yeah, always amazed at the gifts we get for the silent auction. A lot of great music and some signed stuff from David Gann, some glasses, a grinder. We just got all stickers, patches, CDs. You name it, we got it. Also some tie-dyes. Anyway, we have an evening of not only festivities, we have an evening of Grateful Dead heavy festivities. Starting off at 8, Mike Conley will be playing. 9 p.m., Maritime Law. 10 p.m., Twig and Leaf. 11, The Interns. And at midnight, The Traveling Jam. Leaving 1 to 2 open. And also we have the Ram Ones, acoustic Ramones duo, performing between sets for your entertainment. Not to say they're like my monkey and I'm an organ grinder, not that kind of entertainment, but they will be entertaining because I've seen them before. They've been in studio. So I hope to have a lot of my listeners down there. Even if you're not a listener, tell someone who likes the Grateful Dead or this incredible lineup. I mean, you get 6 bands for $8. If that's not a good deal, I don't know what is. For a whole evening of entertainment, I dare say this is the best bang for the buck on September 23rd. In Cincinnati. And if you doubt me, well, hey, okay. All right, well, let's get on with some music here. I'm going to be featuring that my favorite album. I don't think I've played this album in its entirety. I've played a lot of songs off of it, but we're going to be featuring my favorite album from the Grateful Dead, the album that turned me on from the, I guess you could say, the average listener who, you know, is familiar with the radio play, the popular stuff like that, into a hardcore Deadhead, and that was the Skull and Roses album. Phil Lesh wanted to call it, a Skull Beep, but we couldn't call it Skull Beep because it contained the F word. So we aptly named it Skull and Roses. They called it the Grateful Dead, you know, and that's like confusing because, you know, we got an album called that. Why do you want to have a second album called that? It's really confusing me. But they most people call it the Skull and Roses album. It's recorded early in 71 and released a little bit later than that. I'll give you some more information on that album after we get into it, because I'm going to try to play this whole album. It's a double live album, so it's about an hour and 19 minutes long, so I'm going to try to play it all for you guys. So I'm not going to be rambling too awfully much, but don't forget about September 23rd. It's a great way to help WAIF have a good time and hang out with Smokestack Cindy, Taper Jesse, Ramblin Rob, Nice Guy Eddie, you know, the whole crazy morning
crew. These people are hippies. They are occupying a piece of ground in San Francisco's Golden Gate Park, which has come to be called Hippie Hill. They represent a new form of social rebellion. They dress in bizarre and colorful ways. They wear their hair long. Their very name suggests that they are hip, on to something good. They all declare themselves rebels against our society. They like music. The word love is used by them a lot.
Do you know someone like that? Well, if you do, make sure you tell them about that September 23rd WAIF benefit show.
Test me, why don't you arrest me? Don't come around here anymore. I had to move, really had to move. That's why if you please, I'm on my bare knees. Bertha, don't you come around. Mr. Jailer, go away now. Don't tell me no lies. Mr. Jailer, go away now. Don't tell me no lies. When the train goes down, she's rolling down the line. Now.
this rose. It rainbows spiral round and round, it trembles and explodes. It left a smoking crater of my mind, I like the blown away. But the heat come round and busted me for smiling on a cloudy. Thank you. It trembled and exploded like a bus stop in its place. The bus come by and I got home. That's when it all began. There was God.
Got me working, boss man. I work right. I work hard in the daytime. Sure get stoned at night, cause it falls me.
Diesel down just before it rained, took us all the way to New Orleans. I took my harpoon out of my dirty red bandana. I was blowing sad while Bobby sang the blues. With them windshield wipers slapping time, Bobby clapping hands, we finally sang near every song that dragged. Yeah. Freedom's just another word for nothing left to do. Nothing ain't worth nothing, but it's free. Sing the blues. Feeling good was good enough for me. Good enough for me, Bobby McGee.
Feeling good. was good enough for me.
Yeah. lights of the city. For a dime for a cup of coffee. I got no dime, but I got some time to hear a story. My name is August West, and I love my pearly more than my wife. More than my wife. More than my maker, though he's no friend of mine. Everyone said I come to no good. I knew I would really be beaten. Half of my
go again. down the road, feeling bad. Rolling down the road, feeling bad.
Was a little bit of the live Grateful Dead there. That great album, that Skull and Roses album, if some people like to call it. Grateful Dead, whatever. Whatever. So, yeah, you're listening to Ramblin' Rob on WAIF FM. Taper Jesse, how you doing tonight?
I'm doing just fine, Rob. How you doing this evening?
Not too bad, man. Doesn't.
Do you have my arm?
Yeah, I was going to say, it just doesn't sound like you're too awfully loud here.
Yeah, hello.
Yeah, doesn't sound like it.
Oh. So do I need to talk real loud?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, oh, that's horrible. I'm just going to switch the microphone.
I think
that's,
so.
That's really kind of horrible.
How's that?
Whoa. Is that better?
That's, yeah.
Now you can actually hear.
Whoa, that's better. That's way loud. Better. Well, you just caught the entire live Grateful Dead album from 1971. Grateful Dead, Skull and Roses, like I said, on WAIF. Real quick here, going to cover a couple little, technical things. We almost went over an hour without rambling or breaking in or talking. You're only going to get that here on community radio, folks, not all chock full commercials. But we will be telling you about some good things in a little bit. Find Ramblin' Rob on Facebook or Ramblin' Rob's official Greatest Story Ever Told Facebook page. Also have a YouTube channel with about 240 old shows uploaded. And also we'll cover real quick here what happened today in Grateful Dead history before we get to the public service part of our program. Let's see, 1968, the guys played at the Shrine Exhibition Hall in L.A., California, 1969. That was the Paradise Valley Resort in Squamish, British Columbia. Kind of a weird name, isn't it? Squamish?
Squamish?
Squamish.
Squamish.
That's up in Canada, man. That was the Vancouver Pop Festival, eh?
Eh?
1971, the Auditorium Theater, Chicago, first empty pages. 72, Berkeley Community Theater. 1980, the Grand Center up in Grand Rapids, Michigan. 1985, they were at the Boreal Ridge Ski Resort, Donner Summit, California. That was the last day tripper also. So, got a couple things to tell you about. Jesse, you've got some good stuff for the people of Cincinnati to hear, I'm sure.
I sure do. Do you have any pets, Rob?
Yeah, just one cat, Dark Star Kitty.
Yeah.
Did you
get it from a shelter?
No, it actually just wandered into our yard. It was a stray, I guess.
So it's still a rescue cat.
Yeah, kind of. Well, we rescued it. I know we rescued it from a horrible home.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Because I know the owners.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Bad. I'm glad the cat's there. So is he.
You had the option, though. Man, it's a terrible setup. I'm just going to read it.
just read it, man. Just read. Just stick to the... No ad-libbing, man. Just stick to the text, man.
Saturdays from 6 to 8 p.m. Stop channel surfing and dive into the current sound that is the Rockin' and Surfin' Show.
Oh, yeah.
Catch air with Rocket Rick and the Midwest Surf Guy. Longtime surfers, 35 years and counting on the air WAIF 883 on your FM dial. Keep rockin' and surfin'. Visit the Cincinnati Zoo and Botanical Garden located at 3400 Vine Street in Avondale. The zoo is open 7 days a week. That's every day.
Ooh,
yeah. The gates open at 9 a.m. and the park closes at 5. 6 in the summertime. Mm-hmm. For more information about the zoo, call 513-281-4700 or visit their website at cincinnatizoo.org. Want to get wacky on WAIF? Then tune into the Novelty Records radio show every Friday night, Saturday morning from 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. Society of the United States. Our obligations are over, Rob. Are we ready to get back to some tunes?
Because I think so.
Nobody wants to hear my voice.
I think so. Yeah. Let's see. Jerry Garcia Band.
Yeah.
What was it? What was the date, you think?
December 3rd.
12/3/83?
Yeah.
Huh. We'll see if we can find that one in the... that was at the Orpheum Theater, I believe, right? Boston, Massachusetts.
Yes.
12/3/83.
Yeah.
I think he did an early and a late show. And let's see. Yeah, I think so. But anyway, wanted to let you guys know also about the WAIF fundraiser. If you guys are fans of the Jerry Garcia Band, which we're going to be playing as much as this little show as we can get squeezed in the rest of this show. But if you are a fan of the Jerry Garcia Band, I think you want to stop down to Ramblin' Rob's fall fundraiser. Taper Jesse, I will let you, since you have the voice like hot melted butter, tell everybody about this great event.
Saturday, September 23rd, 2017. $8 cover. Urban Artifacts, 1660 Blue Rock.
Yeah, man.
Cincinnati. 8 p.m., Mike Connolly will be favoring you with his guitar stylings. 9 p.m., Maritime Law will be playing things of a fishy nature.
Yes.
Fishy nature.
Fishy nature.
Yes. 10 p.m., Twig and Leaf. 11 p.m., the mighty, mighty sounds of the interns. Yes, and 12 p.m., the traveling jam with tweener sets by the Ram Ones, Ohio's exclusive and probably the world's exclusive.
Yeah. World's only, probably, yeah.
Two-piece acoustic Ramones tribute.
That's right. In addition to that, it'll be held at the Urban Artifact down at, what's the address? I
can't 1660 Blue Rock Street, Rob.
Blue Rock Street.
Blue Rock Street.
Northside, Cincinnati, Ohio. We have a silent auction with all kinds of great gifts. We got records, CDs, patches, stickers. David Gann signed some stuff and sent it to me. We do have some glasses, a grinder, a jar, some tie-dyes, I think a painting.
Some high fives.
Yeah, we got all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
Got all kinds of stuff. So we're going to roll into this great little show from the Jerry Garcia Band. We were making kind of an observation. I don't know if it's true or not. Jesse and I were talking that when Jerry played with the Jerry Garcia Band per se, he tended to rock out a little more, and he had a little, I guess, more more stepping out. I don't know. He just had more fun. It seemed like, yeah, more fun and more enthusiastic, and was, you know, was playing a lot of good Motown stuff and just a lot of like nice you know, up tempo songs. He wasn't trying to drop China Doll on everybody and Roe Jimmy and all that good stuff.
Well, he made up for the lack of China Dolls and Roe Jimmies by pulling out the night they drove Old Dixie down.
Yeah, true.
I'm pretty sure a few times he actually fell asleep while playing that song. It's like,
I wouldn't doubt that. This is an early and a late show. We're going to start off with the early show here from 12-3-83. I think Jerry does a little kicking butt on this show.
Oh, he does a lot of kicking butt on the show, right?
Lay awake all night long. Thank you. so long ago. Looking back, I still remember.